In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, our sister Marianne died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. Can you give me water? May Almighty God bless you and lead you to himself in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And we will have the eulogy now. A Are we having the eulogy? Yeah, okay.
Good morning to the clergy, friend, and family, those watching on the screen. Thank you all for coming today. I'm here to eulogize Marianne Williams, the bravest, strongest, religious, and richest person I have known. When Marie came to this island as a young girl to pursue a life, it was because she wanted to help her mother and siblings back in St. Lucia. She would go further on to bring her younger siblings here, Eula and Anne-Marie, knowing that she would have to be a mother to them. For a young girl in a strange island, taking on that task, that's what I call bravery. Marie later had three children of her own, Juliana, David, and Catherine. Who said a single mother can't do it all? Whilst working and running a household, she always took the time to discipline and make sure that they had respect for people. As a matter of fact, Julianne know not to bring home anything unless she can give an explanation. Christine, that would be me. I joined the family at a very early age. I met Marie working at a summer job. Later, she would take me under her wings and bring me into her household and was always there for me until now. Marie, as I say, was the richest person I know. Didn't have to have silver or gold. First came in love, and that really moved us. Marie was a very religious and ardent member of this church. Every Thursday night, Mom left us and decided to emigrate to the great USA. Catherine was still attending high school, even though Marie knew that she was being taken care of, she gave it up and returned back home because she said that we needed her here, and that we did. When Julian and Kristen was born, Mom was at her happiest. Then came Samantha, Zario, and Adriana. Mom was always proud of our achievement and always let us know it. My proudest moment came when Juliana graduated from the BPF, Barbados Police Force. It was also a bittersweet time in her life because she was scared that she was out there on the street. But Mom know Juliana loved taking risks. Coming home with swollen ankles or elbows off the netball court. Mary was my confidant. She taught me quite a bit. I'm where I am today because she put aside so much for me. Achievement that I acquired through the years because of her. If I said I can't, she would always say, no, Chrissy, you can do it. Mom left her job to look after Kristen, or Didi as we know, to make sure I had the time to do what I wanted to achieve. Maria did not birth me, but when I cried, she cried. When I hurt, she was hurted. But I said this to Juliana, David, Catherine, We had a great life because Mom make it for us. Adriana, Zuriel, and Kristen, I know that you all will have to be here, will love to be here, but life take us to different places, and you all know Ma, she never ever wanted to rain on our parade. Helen, Tonya, Rose, thank you all for being there for Maria. When I walk through these doors, I know I don't have anyone to cry or cling to, but I thank you for being there for us throughout the years. And Juliana, David, Catherine, Julian, Samantha, a message from you guys to Ma, thank you, Ma. And from me, when I came in, it was, hi, Miss Williams. And as I go out, as you go out, it's, boy, Miss Williams, and I love you.
It is with sorrow and grief that today we gather with the mortal remains of our sister, Marie Anne, to entrust her now to the grace and mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ. But we gather also to support one another and to encourage each other with the assurances of our faith, faith in the resurrection of Christ, our Lord, and in the power of his love. God loves us, how often we repeat those words, and we have to believe in them. To you, to the family of Marie Anne Williams and friends, I want to extend my prayers and sympathy. And we want to pray with you during this time, and we also want to pray for you. May the presence of Christ and of his church give you comfort and peace. Please stand. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, who have strengthened us by the mystery of the cross and promise us a share in the mystery of your Son's resurrection, mercifully grant that Marie Anne may be gathered into the company of your chosen ones. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Please be seated, and we will have the first reading now.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the virtuous are in the hands of God. No torment should ever touch them. In the eyes of the unwise, they did appear to die. Their going looked like a disaster. They're leaving us like annihilation, but they are in peace. If they experience punishment as men see it, their hope was rich with immortality. Slight was their affliction, great will their blessing be. God has put them to the test and proved them worthy to be with him. He has tested them like gold in a furnace, and accepted them as a holocaust. They will trust in him. They who trust in him will understand the truth. Those who are faithful will live with him in love. For grace and mercy await those he has chosen. The word of the Lord.
Would the driver of T3721 kindly move your vehicle? T3721.
The second reading from Romans by Yvette Hunt.
That's it. Good morning, church. Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. With God on our side, who can be against us? Since God did not spare his own son, but give him up to benefit us all, we may be certain after such a gift that he will not refuse anything he can give. Could anyone accuse those that God has chosen? When God acquits, could anyone condemn? Could Christ Jesus? No. He not only died for us, he rose from the dead. And there at God's right hand, he stands and pleads for us. Nothing therefore can come between us and the love of Christ. Even if we are troubled or worried or being persecuted or lacking food or clothes or being threatened or even attacked. These are the trials through which we triumph by the power of him who loves us. For I am certain of this, neither death nor life, nor angels, no prince, nothing that exists, nothing still to come, not any power or height or depth, nor any created thing can ever come between us and the love of God, made visible in Christ Jesus, our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Son of Man comes in his glory and all the angels with him, he will sit upon his glorious throne, and all the nations will be assembled before him. And he will separate them one from another as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will place the sheep on his right and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, 'Come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. A stranger, and you welcomed me. Naked, and you clothed me. Ill, and you cared for me. In prison, and you visited me.' Then the righteous will answer him and say, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and welcome you? Or naked and clothe you? When did we see you ill or in prison and visit you?' And the king will say to them in reply, 'Amen, I say to you, whatever you did for one of these least brothers of mine, you did for me.' Then he will say to those on his left, 'Depart from me, you accursed, into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me no drink. A stranger, and you gave me no welcome. Naked, and you gave me no clothing. Ill, and in prison, and you did not care for me.' Then they will answer and say, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty or stranger or naked or ill or in prison and not minister to your needs?' And he will answer them, 'Amen, I say to you, what you did not do for one of these least ones, you did not do for me.' And these will go off to eternal punishment, but the righteous to eternal life. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. This is a very special gospel I just read to you and shared with you, especially when we come for the funeral. But to be honest with you, the more I read this gospel and reflect on it, the more I see how tricky this gospel can be for some of us. And I will try to explain it to you. Look, we have basically the picture of the final judgment, which is coming to all of us. It is just happening to our sister, Marie Anne. But don't deceive yourselves. We will all be in her place in some time from now. All of us, one by one. All of us. There will be time when none of us will be still on this earth. We will have to go through the same judgment that she is going through at this time. And this picture from the gospel is kind of a judgment. God is sharing with us through this gospel, this Matthew's gospel, a picture of what may happen to us, what is going to happen to us. This kind of separation, this kind of division is going to happen, right? This is exactly what we see in the gospel. The good and evil, the truth and falsehood, the sheep and the goats will be separated. Good people and bad people will be separated. Well, we love to say that there is no bad people, right? We are all good. True? Well, God will tell us one day. Look, then the king will speak to those on his right. He will tell them those words which each one of us would like to hear. Words which each one of us expects to hear when we die. Come, you whom my Father has blessed, take for your heritage the kingdom prepared for you since the foundation of the world. Come to me because you belong to me. And they will go happy. And they will ask on the way, but why? When did all of this happen that you are talking about? When did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and make you welcome, naked and clothe you, sick or in prison and go to see you? Look, those good people have no clue when they did it. They are surprised. They just live their lives trying to be as good as they can. They didn't plan anything. And they succeeded in their life. And then the king will answer, I tell you solemnly, in so far as you did all those things to one of the least of these brothers of mine, you did it to me. You didn't even know that you were helping me. And next he will speak to those on his left hand, and he will say something very difficult that most of us are probably very uncomfortable with. How could God even say anything like that, right? God, who is the God of mercy, he will say, go away from me with your curse upon you to the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. Go away from me. Can you imagine God saying these words to anyone? Well, this is exactly what the Bible tells us that he's going to do to some of us. And look, I'm sharing with you all those things not to frighten you in any way, no, or to make it difficult. Look, for Marie Anne, her life's journey is finished. He cannot change anything in her life anymore, but we can. We are still here. we are still having time to change our hearts, to change our lives, to do something. We still have a time, and that's a gift for all of us. So he will say, go away from me because you didn't want to change your heart, although I asked you so many times. Go away because you were always thinking only about yourself and nobody else ever concerned you. Look at your life and then you will know. I tell you solemnly, in so far as you neglected to do this to one of the least of these brothers of mine, you neglected to do it to me, and I gave my life for you, would Jesus probably add. I gave you everything, and you couldn't do anything for me in return. And they will go away to eternal punishment, and the virtuous one to eternal life. And you know, when they think about this gospel, and those things that I was hungry and I was thirsty, I was sick, I was in the prison, I was a stranger, I was naked. This is all the things that we do in life. They are physical things, corporal things, all them, right? But there is something dangerous in this particular passage, because we may start thinking, oh, so if I start doing all those things, I will buy my eternal life doing it, right? Do you think so? Do you think you can earn heaven? This is a question. I would like somebody to say something. Can we earn heaven by our good deeds? No. And Jesus is saying, because I was hungry and I was thirsty, I was a stranger. Why no? Of course we can. We are splitting a little bit now. Can we or we cannot earn heaven? Well, no, we cannot, but there is a but, right? That's why this gospel is a little bit dangerous. Some people may think that, okay, let me do those best things because I know that doing it, I will be admitted to heaven and Jesus will tell me, oh, because you did it to me, right? No, it doesn't work this way. You know why? I don't know if you remember other passages from the Bible, from St. Paul, for example, from his letter to the Ephesians, or St. Peter. Look, it is through grace that you have been saved, St. Paul says. Through grace, right? It is by grace that you have been saved through faith, not by anything of your own, but by a gift from God. Listen to that now and try to put it together with the gospel that we have. And St. Peter says this in the Acts of the Apostles. Remember, we believe that we are saved in the same way as they are. He's speaking about the Gentiles. We are saved in the same way as they are, through the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and not through anything that we do. Wow, now is the thing. Yes, heaven is a grace. Heaven is gift. Salvation, it's a gift from God. There is no good deed big enough to buy us heaven. It's always God's merciful, kind gift to us. But there is this but, you know, by those good deeds that we do towards our brothers and sisters, by extending our kindness and mercy, we are just opening our hearts to receive that gift of salvation. Just imagine someone who has never done any good thing in life, who has never said yes to Christ, who never cared about the church, faith, heaven, or hell. How many people say even these days, I don't care about those things, I just live my life. How can you think that you will be able to say yes to God when you die, when you were never saying yes, when you never said yes to God when you were alive? Basically, I think it's impossible. That's why our life is important. Our daily life, day by day, makes us ready to say yes to God at the end. It's not buying us anything. No, heaven is a gift. It is a grace. But to accept this grace, we have to open our hearts. And as you know, there are people who say no to God in this world. How do they expect to say yes to Him when they die? I don't think it's possible. It has to be a special grace from God to do this. That's why these words, because I was hungry and you gave me food, I was thirsty and you gave me drink, and naked and in prison. That's why it is so important, because little by little it opens up our heart for the final grace, which is salvation. Look, we had a beautiful second reading today, and the message was nothing can separate us from the love of God, right? Well, to be honest with you, there is one thing that can. Have you ever heard about that one? Well, it's us. You can. You and I can say no to God. And that will separate us totally, forever from Him. We have our free will. So nothing from the outside can separate us from the love of God. God's love is greater. But God gave us our free will so we can love Him in return as free people. Right? And there are people who say no to that love. There are people who say no to that grace. That's why our life is important. I didn't know Marianne personally. I came to this parish 2.5 years ago. But I heard a lot of good things about her, being in the choir and being a good person. And we don't do those things. I'm sure she didn't do that calculating in her mind, I have to do those things so one day God will pay me back for my good life and He will say, come, enter my kingdom. No, I don't think she did it this way. She was just a good person, wasn't she? Like we are supposed to be, all of us. Opening her heart day by day, little by little, by singing in the church. Maybe that was her way. Being closer to Him and trying to open as much as she can for the gift, the final gift of salvation that is happening right now. We have the whole life to prepare for that day. You and me as well. We just don't know how long that life will be. Right? So we have to be wise how we live our lives. Being kind, being merciful towards others, being appreciative, inclusive. It's a good thing because one day God may tell you, you know, what you did to this guy or that woman, actually not knowing it, you did it to me. Come, enter my kingdom. Because I was hungry and you did give me food. You helped me when I needed you through other people. I am not paying you back. I am just imagining God saying this. I am not paying you back. You cannot buy salvation for any money. I just see that your heart is open enough and ready to accept the gift that I won for you on the cross. The gift of salvation. So now, take it. Amen, I say to you, whatever you did for one of these least brothers of mine, you did for me. These are beautiful words. And then the King, God, will say, come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. I am waiting for you. He's waiting for all of us. And right now, I do believe that He is welcoming our sister, Marianne. Amen. Please stand. God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and the dead, and in a special way, we want to pray for our sister Marianne. For Marianne, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray, Lord, hear us. For our sister who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on the last day. Lord, hear us. For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness. Lord, hear us. We pray for those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face. Lord, hear us. And we pray for the family and friends of our sister Marianne, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus. Lord, hear us. And for all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom. Lord, hear us. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters, and especially for our sister Marianne. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of your redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Please be seated. We will have the offertory now. And during the offertory, the collection will be taken for masses that we will offer for Marianne throughout the whole year.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for all the good and the good of all his holy church.
Look with favor, Lord, on your servant, our sister Marianne, for whom we offer you the sacrifice of praise, humbly entreating that reconciled with you through these devoted offices, she may merit to rise again to life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Neil, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Marianne, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to sing.
Thank you.
us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you all.
Peace
be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you all. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the words and my soul shall be healed.
Please be seated. Thank you. Let us pray. Please stand. Renewed by this life-giving sacrament, we pray, O Lord, that the soul of our sister Marianne, to whom you gave a part in your covenant, may be purified by the power of this mystery and rejoice without end in the peace of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Trusting in God, we have prayed together for our sister, Marianne, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see her again and enjoy her friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. Almighty God bless you and lead you to himself. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We will repeat now, receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to her aid. Hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Marianne, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon her in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham, and where Lazarus is poor no longer, may you find eternal rest. Whoever believes in me, even though that person die, shall live. I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May God bless you and guide you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Our sister Marianne has gone to her rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome her to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope in eternal life, let us assist him with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with our sister. Together may we meet Christ Jesus when he who is our life appears in glory. Come, you who are blessed by my Father, says the Lord. Inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. This is the will of the one who sent me, says Jesus, that I should not lose anything of what he gave me, but that I should raise it on the last day. Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal bodies. Grant that our sister may sleep here in peace until you awaken her to glory, for you are the resurrection and the life. Then she will see you face to face, and in your light will see light, and she will know the splendor of God, for you live and reign forever and ever. Because God has chosen to call our sister from this life to himself, we commit her body to the earth. For we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory, for he is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our sister to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace her in peace, and raise up her body on the last day. Let us sing now, let's sing together the Blessed Assurance.
Salvation.
And the next one in our booklet is just a closer walk with Thee.
God is satisfied as long.
Let us pray. For our sister Mary Ann, let us pray to our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me shall live even in death, and whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for our sister, and dry the tears of those who weep. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. You wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. Lord, hear us. You raised the dead to life. Give to our sister eternal life. Lord, hear us. You promised paradise to the repentant thief. Bring our sister Marianne to the joys of heaven. Lord, hear us. Our sister was washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give her fellowship with all your saints in heaven. Lord, hear us. And comfort us in our sorrow at the death of our sister. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. Lord, hear us. Now let us pray together as our Lord Jesus Christ has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Almighty God, through the death of your Son on the cross, you destroyed our death. Through his rest in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you. And through his rising again, you restored us to eternal life. God of the living and the dead, accept our prayers for those who have died in Christ and are buried with him in the hope of rising again. Since they were true to your name on earth, let them praise you forever in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need, and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord. May she rest in peace. May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Before the final blessing, let me just share with you one thing. You know, the dead cannot pray for themselves anymore, but we can. And this is our duty, to pray for our deceased as much as we love them. You know, I was just watching you putting those roses and beautiful flowers. It's beautiful, but let's keep those flowers of prayer alive as well. Remember her in your prayers. This is our duty of those who are alive. And you know, one day, maybe somebody will pray for us, for our salvation and for our heaven. It's a good custom to keep for generations. Let's pray for her, not just today, but as long as you remember, as often as you remember, say a little prayer for her, or offer Mass if you come for Masses. That's our duty, and that's our gift for her. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, go and proclaim the gospel of the Lord. May God bless you all. Let's sing at the end from our booklet, Amazing Grace.
Power throughout. Lord.